So the video I'm going to be doing today is do's and don'ts for the talking stage. I have them all written down in my notes. I have a lot of don'ts and a few do's. I don't want y'all to make the same mistakes that I did. So if you want to know do's and don'ts, just keep watching.
Bangs, 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 that's a check, talking. Take all your pants, pants, pants. Bitch, ain't no time for talking. Want me to do my dance, 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 dance. Pants in my pocket, come and get your...
So we're going to start with the don'ts. Number one, don't tell them what you've been through. Do not. I've never done this, but I know for a fact that's not good to do. You wanna know why? Why, Rosé? Why? Tell me. Don't worry, I'll tell you. This generation is so fucked up. Playing games is normalized now. Do not tell them, oh, my ex cheated on me with my brother, my blah, blah, blah. Like, no. Don't tell them because you're giving them ideas. If their intention is to play you, you're just giving them ideas. Don't do it. And also, if I'm talking to someone, I don't like it when they're telling me about people they've talked to before or they're telling me about their ex. That's just weird, first of all. So don't do it. Number two, don't be extra. You should never buy a gift for no man, for no woman that you're not even with. It's not even a bad thing. It's just that you don't want to waste your money on people that don't deserve it. So it's better to just leave all of that out in the talking stage and only do that when you're in a relationship. Who's screaming? I'm guilty of that. Whenever I like someone... Sorry, this is making too much noise. If I like someone, I just want to buy them everything just to show them that I really... like them, but it's better to just leave all of that out. Do it only when you're in a relationship with them, so you know, like, you know, you're not wasting money on someone that doesn't deserve it. Next one, don't have high expectations. If they leave you undelivered, don't deep it. Unless they leave you undelivered, they're posting on their stories. Okay, that's different, because that's just disrespectful. I'm undelivered, but you're posting on your story. People have their own lives. You can't, like, I can't be texting you all 24/7. People have their own lives. People have things to do. It's okay if they leave you undelivered. But if they leave you undelivered and they're posting on their story, then cut them, because that's a red flag. If you're doing that during the talking stage, what are you going to do during the relationship? Cut them out. Another one for high expectation. Don't think you're the only one they're talking to. They may be talking to other people. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Before, I used to be like, this guy better just be talking to me. Now I get it. This generation, like, playing games is normalized. It's best to have options. I'll get into that in the do's, because that's written in my do's. But if they're talking to other people, don't take it personal. Or if you can't handle that, then move on, because you're just gonna get hurt in the end. Don't have high expectations. This is all included into that point. So, like, buying things, buying new things, especially women nowadays, they think that, oh, if this guy asks me on a date, if we're going out to eat, he has to pay for this. Yes, no, he does not. He does not. And I've never thought like that. I've never thought like, oh, he has to buy me this, he has to buy me that. It really does not matter, because I can pay for myself. It really does not matter. Y'all need to stop that stereotype. A man has to buy this. If he offers, then okay, you can pay. But I can pay for myself. I don't need no man to pay for me. Don't show them that you're crazy. I know some niggas be like, oh, I like crazy girls. No, the fuck you do not. Because when they show you crazy, you be acting, you know. That's another red flag. If a nigga or a woman says, oh, I like crazy, they don't like crazy. Because why would you want crazy? If they ever say that, cut them off. What? Why are you looking for some, like... All I can do is shake my head. This one... is the biggest one that I never used to take it. Don't talk for more than 2 months. Don't talk for more than 2 months. Y'all being... I'm saying y'all, including me, because I've done this before. Y'all being talking stages for 6 months, 7 months, 8 to a year. What the fuck? Oh, shit. I know it can be hard, like, if you really like that person and you just want to keep talking to them. But 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, even 3 months, that's too long. Talking stage should be 1 to 2 months max. Okay, and if you're not cuffed by then, cut, move on to the next, cut. Let me tell you, people know what they want. When I know I like someone, I want them before they find anyone else. People know what they want. This boy that I friend zoned, you can tell, like, he really liked me. He would show so much effort. You could just tell he liked me, and he even told me he was planning on cuffing me, okay? People know what they want. He did not want to waste no time. He did not want to waste no time. That's all I'm going to say. He did not want to waste no time. Another example. Me and my ex, we were talking for 4 months. And then we got together, we broke up, whatever. 2 weeks later, he got a new girl. People want what they want. It literally took him 2 weeks just to cuff that girl. Y'all in talking stages for 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. To a year, y'all getting played, or you're getting kept on the side, or I don't know. Most likely,
what?
Most likely, you're getting played. Your time is being wasted. Stop doing that. And I hate it when people are like, "Oh, I need to get to know this." Shut up, because first of all, who is this person dancing on the? Why am I getting distracted? You're not gonna know everything about them in the talking stage. And second of all, you're still gonna learn things when you get together. So why are you telling me you wanna take 6 months? Just no. 2 months max. If you're not cuffed, leave. The way I'm getting angry, because I wish I knew this back then. I've had my time wasted like 3 times already, and it's literally not worth it. I'm still single. I'm not with them niggas. You see what I mean? My time was wasted, or else I got played. Don't do that. Don't do that to yourself trying to wait. No. Also, take mixed signals as a no. Take mixed signals as a no. Especially when I like you, I will get attached. But now I know I'm never gonna do that ever again. I just know it for a fact. I've been through it too much. I'm not going through it again. Take mixed signals as a no. If they really liked you, you would know. You wouldn't be thinking to yourself, oh, does he like me? Oh, blah, blah, blah. Overthinking. You wouldn't be confused. Take mixed signals as a no and just cut. Move the fuck on. What I should have done. What the fuck up? That nigga that was planning on cuffing me, I just knew he liked me. Like, I knew he liked me. But this other nigga, I was just confused, overthinking, thinking to myself, does he like, one day he would be consistent, the next day, like, take mixed signals as a no, take them as a no, and just move on. Next one, don't ignore red flags. This is just obvious. Some people ignore them, like myself. But I know for a fact, I'm not gonna do that shit no more. So this only happened like last week, not even last week, a few days ago. This nigga came to my place. He was like, oh, this bitch better answer. First of all, who are you calling a bitch? Second of all, I was like, oh, I thought you were talking to me. You better not be talking about me. He was like, what are you gonna do, please? Nigga, when I tell you, I was so angry, but I didn't say anything. I just gave him the dirtiest look. He knew. He just knew that I was angry. I was even like, when are you going home? He was even like, when is the next bus? I just wanted him out. What are you saying? Talking about, oh, what are you gonna do, please? That pissed me off. You're in my room, sitting on my bed. Talking about, what are you gonna... What type of disrespect? That was the first red flag and only red flag that I'm getting off him, because I'm never, only would have been like, oh, it's not that deep. Now I'm gonna be like, if you show me one red flag, you're getting cut the fuck off, because I'm not dealing with that bullshit no more. The next one is, don't tell them what your type is. You're probably thinking, what? What, how, like, what? Don't tell them. Some people are fake. If you tell them, oh, I like someone who's religious, I like someone who likes to, and then you see them posting Bible verses, you see them do, people are fake. Do not tell them what your type is. Whenever a nigga asks me that question, all I say is, oh, I like niggas with dreads, some bullshit like that. Obviously I like all types. I don't give a fuck if you have dreads, waves, bald. I don't discriminate. I'm not gonna tell you what I look for in a nigga, so you can go and pretend to be that, and I won't even know who you truly are. Never tell a woman, never tell a man your type. Next would be, don't do anything sexual. So this is for the talking stage. Don't do anything sexual. But also, when you get into a relationship, wait at least 4 months so you can see their true intention. If they're getting annoyed by you not doing anything sexual, cut them off. If they're fine with it, stay with them. If they're getting annoyed, why are you getting annoyed? You definitely don't like me for me, because why are you getting annoyed? The fuck? Especially young girls and young boys, people are pressured into losing their virginity. Especially this generation is fucked up. If you tell someone you're a virgin, they're like, what? You're a virgin? How is that a bad thing? If you're a virgin, keep that till you find someone you love and care for, and they do the same. Especially sneaky links, friends with benefits.
What?
Friends with benefits. All this shit is just disgusting to me. Now, how are you gonna have intercourse with someone you have no connection with? Just pointless sex. I know some people are not gonna agree with me. Y'all need to just save yourself for someone that cares for you and you care for them. It will avoid you from getting emotional attachment. Getting emotional attachment to someone you're not even with is the worst. It's really the worst. And the last don't would be, don't post them during the talking stage. Me and this nigga, we did a TikTok. I posted it from the
top. What?
From the comments, you could just tell that I was getting played. People were tagging other girls, people were fighting in the comments, people were laughing in the comments. It was just clear that I was getting played. And I don't know why. I'm dumb. I can be dumb sometimes. I still continue talking to that nigga.
What?
Now I know next time if you're talking to someone, do not post them, and only post them when you're in a relationship to avoid all this drama, all this bullshit. Moving on to the dudes. So you need to get to know them, have good convos, get to know them, ask them questions. It doesn't matter if it's a dumb question like what's your favorite color. Get to know them, like, and then if you end up together and if his favorite color is blue, you can be like, oh, I remember you said your favorite color is blue, so I got you this blue top. Like, see? Get to know them and have good convos. When I'm talking to someone and if a nigga asks me what you doing every 10 minutes, I'ma just be uninterested, or I'ma just air you or leave you undelivered, because those convos are just so boring. Like, I can't. It's okay to ask like once in a while, but every day, every minute, every hour, what are you doing? Asking what you doing. My replies are gonna be dead, my replies are gonna be slow, I'ma air you or I'ma leave you undelivered, because I hate that so much. Have good convos. It doesn't matter if it's random. It can be a random convo like, oh, what did you have for breakfast this morning? It doesn't matter. Something interesting is better than what are you doing every 5 seconds. Okay, the next one would be, before I used to disagree with this, but now I agree with it. It would be to ask them what you want. Like I said, this generation is fucked up. You never know what people want, so it's better to ask them. If they want friends with benefits, then cut. You don't want that. If they want a relationship, then stay. Or if they're telling you, oh, we'll see how it goes, we'll go with the flow, that's a red flag right there. Cut them off. Because they're either going to play you, they're going to waste your time, they're not serious. So I remember this nigga told me before, he was like, oh, we'll just go with the flow and see how things go. We did not end up with each other. They need to know what they want, and you obviously know what you want. You want a relationship, that's why you watching this video, innit? I don't know. This is for the people who want a relationship, or if you want friends with benefits, then go ahead. But this, if you want a relationship and they're telling you we'll go with the flow, that's a red flag. Cut them off and move on. This point would be, this next one is, be yourself. So this nigga, he DM'd me. Everything was going good until I told him I smoke weed. The whole vibe just changed. It was like he was judging me for smoking weed. It's not like I'm injecting heroin into my bloodstream. Relax. We just stopped talking after that. I don't understand. Like, how dumb is that? You don't see me going, oh, I don't like him because he doesn't like Nicki Minaj. Do you hear how stupid that sounds? Okay to have differences. If you don't smoke, that's okay, that's cool. But if I do, you gonna stop talking to me because of that?
What
the fuck? But all me would have been like, oh, I don't smoke anymore, just to keep talking to him. But now I was telling him like, why are you acting as if it's heroin? It's just weed. Relax, be yourself, don't change. Because I could have been like, oh, I stopped just to keep talking to him. I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna be myself. Also, don't try and impress them. If you know they like anime, don't force yourself to watch anime just because they like it. It's okay to have differences. Even if you don't have anything in common, it's okay. It's okay to be your own person. You don't have to like what they like just to try and get them to like you, or just to try and impress them. The next one would be, go on dates. Y'all be in talking stages. Y'all be talking to people, but y'all don't link. And take note, if you go to a restaurant, even McDonald's, I always clean up after myself. Shit like that. If they don't do that, basic manners. I don't know. Even how they interact with like the waiters, the waitress, basic manners like saying thank you, please, thank you. And even if you go to their house, see how they interact with their parents, see how they interact with their siblings. They're rude, they're most likely gonna be rude to you. Don't ignore that shit, because all of that is important. They don't say thank you to the bus driver.
What?
I hate that. Like, basic manners. If they don't have any of that, it's a red flag. Move on to the next. Have options. Before, I used to disagree with this, but I don't disagree with it no more, because this generation, again, generation, everything leads back to this generation. It's fucked up. Playing games is normalized. You need to have options. Don't put your all into just one person, because you never know, they could be playing you. You never know. Like, when me and this nigga had a fight, I just remember his friend telling me, why are you fighting him? Why are you doing this? Why are you trying to hit him? You were just with this boy. So I wasn't fighting him over a girl. I was fighting him because he was playing with my feelings, first of all. Second of all, I know for a fact that nigga was not loyal, so why should I stay loyal for someone that's not even mine? But that was all my points for the talking stage, do's and don'ts. Y'all better not make the mistakes that I made, because I know for a fact I'm done. But yeah, that was it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and goodbye.